盲人摸象。
The blind man and the elephant. Learning outcomes. By the end of this lesson, you are expected to read the text, The Blind Man and the Elephant, with the appropriate pronunciation and intonation. Understand and summarize the text.
你好，今天我们来学习盲人摸象的课文。Today, we will read the text entitled The Blind Man and the Elephant.
请注意听。
Listen carefully.
听后回答问题。
Listen and answer the questions.
听力开始。
Now, let's start.
一天，有四个盲人一起去街上玩。
One day, four blind men went together on the street to have fun.
他们正在街上聊天的时候，
While they were chatting on the street,
一个人骑着大象过来。
A person came riding an elephant.
问他们知不知道大象的样子。
And asked the blind man if they knew how the elephant looked like.
他们都说不知道。
All of them said that they didn't know.
因为他们都是盲人。
Being all blind.
所以他们就用手去摸大象。
They used the hands to touch the elephant.
第一个盲人摸到了大象的腿，粗粗的。
The first blind man touched the elephant's thick leg and
他就说大象像一个柱子。
Said that the elephant was like a pillar.
第二个盲人摸到了大象的尾巴，长长的。
The second blind man touched the elephant's long tail and
他就说大象像一根绳子。
Said that the elephant was like a rope.
第三个盲人摸到了大象的肚子，大大的。
The third blind man touched the elephant's big stomach and
他就说大象像一面墙。
Said that the elephant was like a wall.
第四个盲人摸到了大象的耳朵，圆圆的。
The fourth blind man touched the elephant's round ear and
他就说大象像一把扇子。
Said that the elephant was like a fan.
四个盲人都没说对。
None of the four blind men answered correctly.
这个故事告诉我们，看问题要全面。
This story tells us that we have to look at problems from a comprehensive perspective.
练习
Exercise.
回答问题。
Answer the questions.
第一题。
Question one.
四个盲人为什么去摸大象？四个盲人为什么去摸大象？答案
Answer.
因为他们都是盲人
Being all blind.
都不知道大象的样子
They didn't know how the elephant looked like.
所以他们就用手去摸大象
So they used the hands to touch the elephant.
我们来看课文内容。
Let's look at the text.
他们都说不知道。
All of them said that they didn't know.
因为他们都是盲人。
Because all of them were blind.
所以他们就用手去摸大象。
They used their hands to touch the elephant.
第二题。
Question 2.
为什么第一个盲人说大象像一个柱子？为什么第一个盲人说大象像一个柱子？答案
Answer.
因为第一个盲人摸到了大象的腿，粗粗的。
Because the first blind man touched the elephant's thick leg.
我们来看课文内容。
Let's look at the text.
第一个盲人摸到了大象的腿，粗粗的。
The first blind man touched the elephant's thick leg and...
他就说大象像一个柱子。
Said that the elephant was like a pillar.
第三题。
Question 3.
为什么第二个盲人说大象像一根绳子？为什么第二个盲人说大象像一根绳子？答案
Answer.
因为第二个盲人摸到了大象的尾巴，长长的。
Because the second blind man touched the elephant's long tail.
我们来看课文内容。
Let's look at the text.
第二个盲人摸到了大象的尾巴，长长的。
The second blind man touched the elephant's long tail and...
他就说大象像一根绳子。
Said that the elephant was like a rope.
第四题。
Question 4.
为什么第三个盲人说大象像一面墙？为什么第三个盲人说大象像一面墙。答案
Answer.
因为第三个盲人摸到了大象的肚子，大大的。
Because the third blind man touched the elephant's big stomach.
我们来看课文内容。
Let's look at the text.
第三个盲人摸到了大象的肚子，大大的。
The third blind man touched the elephant's big stomach and...
他就说大象像一面墙。
Said that the elephant was like a wall.
第五题
Question 5.
为什么第四个盲人说大象像一把扇子？为什么第四个盲人说大象像一把扇子？答案
Answer.
因为第四个盲人摸到了大象的耳朵，圆圆的。
Because the fourth blind man touched the elephant's round ear.
我们来看课文内容。
Let's look at the text.
第四个盲人摸到了大象的耳朵，圆圆的。
The fourth blind man touched the elephant's round ear and
他就说大象像一把扇子。
Said that the elephant was like a fan.
第六题
Question 6
四个盲人都说对了吗？四个盲人都说对了吗？答案
Answer
四个盲人都没说对。
None of the blind men answered correctly.
我们来看课文内容。
Let's look at the text.
四个盲人都没说对。
None of the blind men answered correctly.
总结。
Recap.
一天，有四个盲人一起去街上玩。
One day, four blind men went together on the street to have fun.
他们正在街上聊天的时候
While they were chatting on the street,
一个人骑着大象过来
A person came riding an elephant.
问他们知不知道大象的样子
And asked the blind man if they knew how the elephant looked like.
他们都说不知道。
All of them said that they didn't know.
因为他们都是盲人。
Being all blind.
所以他们就用手去摸大象。
They used the hands to touch the elephant.
第一个盲人摸到了大象的腿，粗粗的。
The first blind man touched the elephant's thick leg and
他就说大象像一个柱子。
Said that the elephant was like a pillar.
第二个盲人摸到了大象的尾巴，长长的。
The second blind man touched the elephant's long tail and
他就说大象像一根绳子。
Said that the elephant was like a rope.
第三个盲人摸到了大象的肚子，大大的。
The third blind man touched the elephant's big stomach and
他就说大象像一面墙
said that the elephant was like a wall.
第四个盲人摸到了大象的耳朵，圆圆的。
The fourth blind man touched the elephant's round ear and
他就说大象像一把扇子。
Said that the elephant was like a fan.
四个盲人都没说对。
None of the four blind men answered correctly.
这个故事告诉我们看问题要全面。
This story tells us that we have to look at problems from a comprehensive perspective.
今天我们学了盲人摸象的课文，希望你喜欢这堂课。Today, we have read the text entitled The Blind Man and the Elephant. Hope you have enjoyed this lesson. 再见。